Well, it's become common wisdom to say that if it weren't for the media, attitudes towards gay Americans and same-sex marriage in particular wouldn't have changed as dramatically as they have over the past few years. But common wisdom is common because it's at least partially true. Look at Will and Grace, Modern Family, Glee, and even Sean Penn winning an Oscar as Harvey Milk, just to name a few.
Our next two guests may or may not agree with that assessment, but they're using the media, BRIC community media to be specific, to have their own say about sexual and gender identity. The work of these Brooklyn free speech producers will be shown this Sunday in a special free outreach program called LGBTQ Stories at the Bishop in Crown Heights. We want to welcome Lester Matthews. Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
And then the legendary Sheba Legend. Welcome back to BK Live.
Thanks for having me back.
And this is our community corner. We're glad to have you guys here. So we want to know, what made you decide to become community producers?
Wow, I've been blogging since 2008, originally from New Orleans, Louisiana. And I moved to LA. And then by moving to New York, this great opportunity came along for me to take advantage of this space and equipment. And it really encouraged me and motivated me to want to do more with my craft.
Okay.
So that's like a really good thing for me, yeah.
Okay, okay.
I'm an accidental community producer.
Okay.
This is my fifth year with BRIC in developing a project, specifically MasculineUs and the 15 Minutes Project. Mm-hmm. I didn't come here for this. I came here to kind of loiter and see what was going on. And I ended up taking a class that was definitely within my budget, and I ran with everything that they gave me from that point on, and I have two projects out of that beginning, so I'm really happy about the whole thing.
We should all be so lucky as to loiter as well.
I know.
She
kept it real. I was like, I have to loiter somewhere.
But we're sitting here, it's June, there's Pride Month stuff all over,
right.
But
yes.
One of the things that is so often not seen in Pride is a face of a brown person, a colored person,
right.
And you guys, in your work, open the door to a place that a lot of people haven't seen, whether it is in terms of sexuality or of race, and the intersection of race and sexuality. Was that something that's intentional?
Yes, that's what I try to do and strive for, being African-American, openly gay man in America. Mm-hmm. We are totally different, diverse people, and my blog's really focused on letting people view my experiences through my eyes. And I think that's when my viewers got out of my experiences, my stories, my documentaries,
right.
And my celebrity interviews.
Okay.
Because everyone is totally different. I know Sheba, she's have a screening coming up on the 22nd.
Yeah.
And she's portraying a MasculineUs.
Yeah, MasculineUs is a ongoing human rights project that's not for profit. And in MasculineUs, I focus on women who carry a position of the spirit. That's usually translated into masculine traits, and that's something that goes all the way across the board with women. We're really not concerned with your sexual preference. We've discovered this energy in women who are married, grandmothers who have grandchildren who carry the same energy, and we focus on each individual's and their challenges, whether they were past or present, with carrying this energy that can't be beaten, raped, costume over or prayed out of them.
Okay.
So it's something that is part of a ongoing global phenomenon of violence against women who carry this
energy. Okay, then let's take a look.
We have to find our histories. We have to identify them, we have to acknowledge them, and we have to make them common knowledge. What's important about the MasculineUs project is that it is the potential to open up a global dialogue. And in that global dialogue, we get to ask ourselves a lot of, questions. How do we deal with people who may look different than we look? Do we accept them? Do we welcome them into the fold, or do we reject them? And if we are choosing to reject them, why are we rejecting them? So I think that's why this MasculineUs project is really important on a global level. the struggle continues.
It is global, and it's happening right here in Brooklyn in our backyard. Thank you for sharing that, Sheba.
Thanks for being part of the dialogue.
And folks can see it when?
May 22nd at the Bishop Gallery, but we do have a website, www.masculineus.com. Okay. You can, you know, we want people who also, especially perpetrate violence against women of our demographic, to come in and tune into our website to get visually shift, to have your perspective shift.
Yeah.
Maybe that'll stop. Well, you'll think twice about committing that act against another human being.
Okay, and in the future. You do a combination of?
Oh, I do everything. I have documentaries, celebrity interviews. My website is YoBoiNewNue.com. Mm-hmm. And basically, I do documentaries. I follow the lives of different people who people don't normally see in front of the camera or, you know, in front of the camera. So
okay, well, we have a clip of your work too. So let's take a look.
Good stuff.
Last time on Cali Living.
Oh, you are?
Yeah.
That's what's up. How's it going?
Yeah, I really like him.
You do?
You're dealing with a breakup.
Matt is a very attractive guy, so I would say I'm attracted to him in many ways.
You in the back for a reason. That's the non-talking section.
What's up? My name is Sean. I'm 30 plus years old, born and raised in Los Angeles.
I hit up the whole crew like, yo, we should go to Palm Springs. James' friend Anthony is having a birthday out there and we want to surprise.
Warren invited me to come to Palm Springs to surprise one of his friends for his birthday.
We're like, surprised, and he's like, oh.
So we like, yeah, what's up? Like, turn up. And they all kind of just like,
regardless if it's the birthday boy is happy to see us or not, I'm just happy that we're all here together and we can have a good experience.
We get back to the hotel and everybody is like turned up. You know, we just finished having some drinks.
Newnue comes up with this great idea to have this game where we ask questions, lies and gay rumors, where everybody got to ask a question that they really want somebody else to answer in the room for them.
Are you and Warren dating?
I'm like,
Wow. We were wondering, is that real? No, that was
we
great
see
work.
Yes,
we see you.
This is actually a documentary I have online. I have two episodes left. Okay. It's on my YouTube channel. It's called My Experience Cali Living.
Cali Living.
Two more episodes left is currently airing right now. So it's a good show.
So now let's talk about this upcoming event one more time in Crown Heights.
Bishop Gallery, that's June 22nd. Mm-hmm. I think it's from 5 to 10.
Nine. Mm-hmm.
5 to 9, 4 hours of screening. I think it's a 10-minute piece.
Social gathering.
Social gathering, questions and answers, big flying hugs.
I'm actually screening a documentary of a transgendered woman because the transgender community is that type of, you know, people that get overlooked on equality. So I want to share that at the gallery on Sunday.
Sunday at the Bishop in Crown Heights.
We know what we're doing this weekend. Thank you for sharing and continuing to do the work that you do, giving voice to a community that's not often heard.